Fear is actually the opposite of love. When we think of love, we usually think the opposite is hate, when fear is actually the opposite. Because if we hate somebody, we are in our ego, in our egoic mind, but it doesn't keep us trapped. And fear is what actually keeps us trapped and limited and not stepping outside of our comfort zone, stepping outside of the normal conditioned systems. And in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you why fear is holding you back from actually getting out of the matrix. So our fears is always what is holding us back in life from taking that leap, from asking that person out, from taking that journey, taking that leap of faith, whatever it is, to going on that business adventure, starting your business, whatever it may be. Fear will keep us trapped and limited in a prison cell. And because we are constantly in the ego mind of our beliefs, we will identify with our fears. And our fears are all of our beliefs, the beliefs about ourselves. And we always seem to think, well, that's who I am, because these beliefs are telling me this must be true about myself, because my external reality is reflecting that back to me, because we are holding onto these beliefs. And the confirmation bias that we use to say, well, that's true, that's true, that's true, is reaffirming your limiting beliefs, which are fear-based beliefs. And this is what keeps us in this loop, this perpetual cycle of fear and not stepping out of our comfort zones, because as well, our fears are programs. And that is what the matrix is. And the matrix will just tap in a few little things and program us to believe certain things about ourselves. And fear-based beliefs are often things of judgment, fear of judgment, fear of what will happen. Our ego will project something into the future, it will attach to the future and think the worst case scenario. And so we always have fear of what might happen, fear of failure, fear of success, fear of other people's comments or negative comments. And I just want to take this moment to remind you, no matter how far you are in your soul's evolution, in your spiritual journey, your self-development journey, whatever you want to call it, this human experience, there's always going to be somebody that will drag you down. So there's no point in worrying about it, and always come back into the present moment, because nothing exists outside of the present moment. So our fears will keep us trapped in this limited prison cell, and we can only move, certain diameters, certain steps until we feel, well, we can't go any further. And I'm here to tell you that you have the keys to unlocking that prison cell and going forth and living your dream life and getting out of that matrix prison cell. And so, why do we always have these fear-based beliefs about doing things differently? Because that's what it is. If we want to get out of the matrix, you are stepping away from the systems, whether that's going off grid, homeschooling, homesteading, whatever it may be, just your spiritual journey is doing things a little bit different to what people see in everyday society. We have these fear-based beliefs because it's kind of ingrained in our DNA, in the human evolution. We used to live in tribes, and often if we didn't follow what other people said and it was peaceful, if we stirred the pot a bit, did things differently, we would get outcast, wouldn't we? And when we're outcast, that means death, when we're on our own, for example, in the jungle, wherever it may be. And that's a deep rooted ancestral belief we all carry with us. And so we want to fit into the tribe. We don't want to cause a fuss, cause a scene, because I want to survive. And that's all this is as a survival mechanism. So there's another way why we hold on to these fear-based beliefs. It's all the programming we've been exposed to as children. So in the form of trauma, in the form of parents telling us that we're not good enough, they're critical, they're judgmental. So we hold on to that wound, that experience, and it forms deep-rooted beliefs. And this often means we start people-pleasing and attuning to everybody else's needs because ours weren't met. But that's how we got our needs met as a child. So then when we're people-pleasing, we want to keep people happy. So if we are going to step out of the matrix and do things radically different and get away from all those systems, it's going to scare us because we're so used to people pleasing, if that's you, because often we don't want to cause a scene because we're feared that we're going to be judged, we're going to be criticized, it's going to be humiliating, because that belief you've held on to since you were a child. But the liberating thing is you don't want those kind of people in your tribe when you're trying to make a radical decision, get out of the matrix, have your dream life. So it's okay to let go of those people that are no longer serving you. You don't want them in your tribe anyway. And this applies in my own life. When I went through my spiritual awakening at the beginning of 2021, I felt like a closet spiritual person. I felt different. I felt like I no longer could fit into society, and I felt like I couldn't be myself. And when I wanted to go to like a group meditation, a sound bath, like I felt like I had to shrink myself and not really tell people where I was going, what I was doing, because it's too woo-woo. And the word woo-woo is just another matrix programming belief to make it sound ridiculous rather than it being our true nature. So I was stopping myself from enjoying my own life, from growing, because the fear of being seen as a spiritual person, because people think I'm ridiculous, you're a hippie. I was coming up with all these bullshit stories in my head of why I couldn't express my spirituality. And I believe a lot of light workers, a lot of spiritual people that are waking up now are feeling like that. And if this is you, comment below, let me know what your thoughts think, and like this video. So when we are holding on to all these programmed beliefs, our subconscious gets programmed and we get stuck and trapped in this prison cell that is actually designed to be like this. So the matrix, the systems that are all in place in the world, are designed to actually keep us in fear, keep us locked in that fear. And it does this by the media, it does this by education, it does this by pumping us with so much information that is negative, and we often become desensitized to certain things because they are pumping us with so much fear-based information. And one of the things they've done recently, you might be aware of, that instilled fear in the whole of humanity was the thing that happened 3 years ago now. The systems that are in place manipulate humanity, so then we are constantly in that fear state, the vibration of fear, heavy, dense, negative feelings that get stuck in our body. We are programmed and implanted with all of these negative programs that keeps us from owning our true potential and stopping us from having that key to unlocking that prison cell. So they'll say everything alternative is woo-woo, no scientific proof, and everything has to be scientifically proven these days. And if it's not, it's a load of nonsense. And they'll manipulate you to believe what they want you to believe. And that's where the media comes in. And so many people are waking up now so that they can come out and get out of the matrix system. And we hold ourselves back because we are so instilled with fear of the judgment, because we have collectively agreed that in order to survive, we must compete, we must people please, we must stay and stick with the tribe. And it's created this kind of hive mind, and we don't think for ourselves. So then we stay in the matrix, because there are so many people now that are spiritually awake, spiritually aware, but they're still operating from the 3D reality matrix because they are ingrained with fear. And there are so many people that now realize that they were manipulated by the big thing that happened. I think people are fear of judgment. So this is the collective belief that we must fit in. We must please, we must obey, we must survive. And that's not a bad thing. But what needs to happen here now is different communities coming together to help us ascend into the 5D consciousness. And often I hear things like, well, I don't have the money to do things differently. It's all right for them. They've got this, this, and this, which some of that is true. But all these are just your fear-based beliefs of why you feel you can't do it. So you keep yourself trapped in this prison cell. And then you go about your daily life, go into your 9-to-5 system, your 9-to-5 job that keeps us stuck in this perpetual cycle. And the cabal, the elite, whatever you want to call it, is laughing at us when we are just unconsciously, willingly going about our day and not taking that leap of faith to come together. And this is not to say people aren't doing this, because there are people doing this, people like coming together now, and we are moving to more towards that. But if you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe, because it's my mission to share my message as far as possible and to help you to realize that you hold the keys to your true potential. So with that being said, I will see you on the next video. Much love.